Okay, so the tutorial that I'm going to be doing is for a Afro kinky twist. I'm going to be adding extensions to my hair. I'm going to be braiding here at the root and then twisting. And the hair that I bought was the Nappy Collection Afro Puffy Twist in 1B. And this is the hair. This is the hair that I got. I could not find this hair in my local beauty supply, and I'm here in Michigan, so I actually ordered it online. It's at $9.99. I did buy two of these. I'm going to post it right here so you can see. The shipping was very fast. I got it in 3 business, and I went through PayPal. So altogether, with the shipping and 2 packs of hair, I paid $24.98, and that was much better than other prices I found for like $34 for just 2 packs. So again, I paid $24.98 for 2 packs, including shipping. Great job. Anyway, this is the hair. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to wash my hair. I'm going to deep condition it. But at least I'm happy that I do have some growth. Look at that. Forgive me, I look tired right now. It's a lot going on. But anyway, God is good. He is awesome, people. He is faithful, okay? Faithful. Do you guys see this? I hope you can see it. Natural, blow dried. Yeah. Let me show you the back. I can comb through it, so that's a plus. It's not super straight, but you don't need your hair to be super straight just to braid it. And for those of you who are opposed to blow drying, don't blow dry. My hair looks like a mullet. Look at that. So this is my hair straightened out as much so I can get it braided. And again, this is my blowout at 5 months. And I'm going to try to move as quickly as I can because I don't want it to revert too much. I probably just twist it up in sections so that it stays straight. But anyway, this is my hair at 5 months to blow out. So I'll just turn around so you can see. And as you guys can see, it is very thick. Look at that, y'all. Nice hair growth. One thing that I've decided to do is that the middle part, the crown part of my hair, mostly this part right here, this whole little thick part right up here, I am going to corn roll that part, and I'll be latch hooking the twist on there to save time. Now that you've parted out your top section like this, you need to decide if it's too much hair or if it's not enough, because remember, you're going to have this part right here is going to be full of braids. If your hair is pretty thick like mine, you're going to want to section your hair in parts like this, or some kind of form to keep it semi-straight when you get ready to braid it. I know this part looks a little crazy, a little weird, but my goal is to keep my hair straight from sweating out and frizzing back out. I don't want to ruin the blow dry I did, the blowout. So this is the section that I have it parted now. This part right here, I know it's not perfect, but this part I'm about to section off, and I'm going to braid it in a zigzag pattern. So now I've braided up the middle part, and I've sectioned off my hair, not so much as to braid it, but to keep it from reverting. The middle part that I braided. Excuse me. Some people like to go this way. What is that? Vertical? I went horizontal. I think that's right. It's like 3 a.m. Anyway, I chose to do my pattern this way because I wanted my, when I latch up them in, I want them to fall and, you know, be that way to fill in each other instead of having gaps in between. That's just my preference. Some people choose to braid in a circle, in a beehive, but I like mine to lie as flat as possible so I don't like it to, you know, build up or anything. And then I didn't know how my hair was going to hold. That it is holding pretty well. It's not perfect, but it is enough to get done what I need, and it's tight. I didn't think it would be so tight.